I'm here with Jimmy, this is Jim's dad, and I just wanted to ask you, what did you think when Jim first came to you and said, I'm going to be a singer, you know, when he's just starting out, what did you say?
I said, you couldn't sing to save your life.
Okay, and what did he say to that?
He was quite annoyed.
I'm going to do it anyway.
Shadow, let go, there's something you should know. I find my new direction, and I hope you like the key, like the air that led me to it. That sucked me through it. She's a river turning there in front of me. Stand back, get back. She'll paint your blue skies black. Spirit of creation, last chance guaranteed. Step out the loose, get me traveling shoes. She's a river turning there.
I'm a walker. I mean, I think it's not very typical for rock and rollers. Are meant to be, you know, fast living and fast cars and all that. I'm not interested in any of that stuff at all. I love walking. It's no coincidence, perhaps, that the title of the new album is Walk Between Worlds. It's a chance to get some kind of natural thinking done, you know, because I always find when you walk as well, I don't meditate. I wish I could. And I love the idea of meditation in terms of the you know, classical meditation. But I find walking is a sort of meditation for me.
I've got to say that actually that is technically a meditation.
It is,
you know,
yeah.
You're switching off, you're focusing on one thing.
Get out and walk wherever we are, whether that's in Rome or Buenos Aires. Or kind of head towards the water, and hence the waterfront. Even Charlie and I used to do a lot of hikes together, and some spectacular ones. I think the best one we did was, we once did this 7-day trek through the desert in Jordan, and we ended up in Petra, the famous rose city on the, it's a Silk Road. I think they famously used it in Indiana Jones or one of those movies. But Charlie and I were out there for 7 days, slept under the stars with Bedouins. You find solutions, ideas pop up, or you find a clarity of idea. Can be a song. A lot of the lyrics come when I'm walking as well.
So what happens when you have these ideas? They come into your head. Do you hear things in your head? Like, how do the ideas come about?
Where do they come from? Why is it? That's a great question. I think what it is, I think if you're artistic, you're always kind of unknowing. You're absorbing stuff, and for me it could be something I've read, it could be something someone says, it could be something I've heard, and you're kind of putting it into the pool, you're kind of stocking stuff up, and at a certain point I'll go, Charlie will play me something, or as I was saying to you earlier, a rhythm will, you know, pop up, and I'll go, oh, I know the phrase, I've got a phrase with the same rhythm.
Like the air that led me to it, wind that sucked me through it. She's a river turning there in front of me. Stand back, get back, she'll paint your blue skies black. Spirit of creation, last chance guaranteed. Skip out.
So Jim, which element of this landscape is the thing that inspires you to write? Is it the water? Is it the rocks?
I mean, there has been certain places that we've written songs about, specifically the place we were earlier at the Falls of Dochart. There's a song in real life called Rivers of Ice, which I used to go up there in the winter, and it literally was. And we used as a very Highland melody, and so we certainly got a song out of that. But there's a song that a lot of Simple Minds fans will know from our Street Fighting Years album called This Is Your Land, which it kind of says in the title. The lyrics in it talk about the old world, especially around here. The old railway tracks is one of the lyrics. We've been on some of them today. Churches and steeples, everywhere you go, here's a little church. Also, there's a verse in it. The thing that really saddens me, it touches me about, and this will go for villages all over Europe and all over Britain, is every little village you look here, and there's a statue, men and women, who died in the army, who died in the forces during the war and all that, and that that paid to a lot of the villages here. the young people went away, they never came back. So that's one song in particular that I think is a portrait of some of the emotions that I felt when I walked through these landscapes. Apprenticeships, but Charlie and I knew that was only a way for us to get money for amplifiers and microphones, and because we were still at night, call it woodshedding, we were still trying to learn songs and practicing and thinking maybe an opportunity will come up. And so we worked on building sites. The whole punk thing came along, and Charlie and I got involved in that, and we've 6 months of back of a van going up and down and just learning to get in front of an audience, writing some songs. After 6 months we thought, let's get serious. First Simple Minds song started to emerge, and the idea of the band, and we found Michael McNeil, the keyboard player. He was the only guy in Glasgow with a synthesizer. And within a short time we started getting reviews in the weekly music papers and record companies. I would hitchhike down to London with demo tapes and try and get a record deal. We'd no manager or nothing.
Where did you go then when you went down to London?
The guy who worked in the record shop in Glasgow, I didn't know anything, and he would say, I'll give you the addresses of the record companies, just knock on the door, ask for the A&R guy.
Oh, right.
He'll listen to you. And of course I would go down, could we see the A&R guy? They'd be like, no. Have you got an appointment? Of course, all that, we were that green. But the trick was, we didn't know it was a trick, or the fortune was, we didn't get to see the A&R guys, but the receptionists were usually young girls, they were young guys. We would kind of charm them and say, well, maybe you want a cassette or whatever. And on a number of occasions, the receptionists took their Listen for My cassettes, they would play them. And as they and our guys were walking in and out of lunch, they would go, well, who's that? You're in my problem. That's where I'm going with you. Let's go.
I remember he said to me, I'm going to give me a lift, I'm playing in this pub. And I said, aye, so I took him down. And I seen about 100 people waiting at the pub. And I said, what are these people waiting for? He says, me. I says, it must be off their head.
We had local fans. We had about 150 fans, Glasgow, and they were so... They joined our crusade, helped us with posters, helped us get vans together, helped us... We didn't know we were doing it, but we were putting this organisation, and it seems, people have told me, we didn't know, but it seems that we were really great at organising ourselves, and as well as learning. There was better bands than us, more talented than us, but they probably weren't as good at hustling.
Where do you think that came from, that ability to hustle?
Jen, I think you're born a type. You're born, first of all, to be able to envisage, and then an energy to you know, push it through against whatever odds. And sometimes being green is great when you're that naive, because you don't know that you've got no chance. You just think, why not? It's funny, Scotland, because I love Kathmandu, I love the area around Nepal, Tibet, all of that, but some places in Scotland are equally as spectacular and equally as spiritual and all of that, and it's where I'm at home. They're laughing. The ducks are laughing.
Do you have a laugh?
They're like,
really?
Cheeky wee bastards.